Hello everyone, this is the part 2 of making a continuous speech recognition app in MIT App Inventor. If you haven't watched part 1 yet, then go and first watch that by clicking this I button. Okay, so in part 1 we had coded this app something like this, that whenever we turned on this switch and talked something, all our speech would be recorded and shown up here in this label. In this part, we'll change this label and use a list view so that all our speech would be shown one by one, will be saved and shown one by one in the list view. Okay, so let's start. First, let's delete the label which we had coded in part 1, which we don't want now. Okay. Okay, so in part 1 we had coded for the switch that whenever the switch would be turned on, then the clock should be turned on. And whenever the clock is enabled, then what it should do? It should call the speech recognizer to get text. Okay, so now we won't discuss anything about this. Just copy and paste it and your switch will work. And the voice recognition would also work. Okay, so now we want the app to work with a list view. So first of all, let's drag and drop a list view to the screen. And let me set the align vertically to top so that it comes to the top. Now, for this list, for the words to be shown in the list viewer, we need to create a variable. So go to the block section and click on variables. Drag and drop the initialized global name to block in the screen. Okay, so let's name this variable as dictation, or you can name it anything you want. Okay, so dictation is meant by create an empty list so that it creates it makes the list empty. So click on the lists and get a create empty list block and attach it to the variable. Okay, so initialize global dictation to create empty list. This is the variable. Now we need to only code the speech recognizer. So click on the speech recognizer and get the block after getting text. Drag and drop it. After getting text, it should modify the dictation variable. And as the dictation variable is made with list, so click on lists and get the block add items to list. Drag and drop it. Okay, now click on variables, get the get block and set it to global dictation. Okay, so add items to list, get global dictation, and then click on result and drag and drop it. Okay, so the after getting text, the list should be modified by setting the dictation variable with the result. Okay, so they both should collaborate. Now we want the list view to get our text, to get what we say. So click on list view, get the list view elements block, and we need to, after getting the text, we need the list view to list view elements to display the result, to display our speech, and our speech is the result, and the result is been modified by the global dictation. So we again need another global dictation block. Drag and drop and modify it. Okay, so after getting text, the list of the global dictation variable should be modified with the result, and then the elements and then the list view should display the global dictation, which means our speech. Okay, that's done. Now if you want the app to repeat your text, repeat whatever you say and respond to you like this, that whenever I say hello, the app also should say hello first and then write it down to the list view. Okay, so for that we will need a text to speech. Go to the media section and drag and drop that into the screen. Now go to block section and click on text to speech. Call text to speech to speak message. Okay, so what message should be speaked? Whatever we say should be repeated, so the result should be speaked. So attach the get result variable. Okay, so now that's done. Now if I want to clear whatever I say after some words, like if I don't want the words to stay anymore, then I want to clear the words. Okay, clear the words from the list view. So I will need a button. go to user interface and get the button to the screen. I will name the button as clear and set the font size to 20. You can also set the background color. So I am giving that dark gray and the text color to white. Okay, so whenever we click the clear button, go to block section and the clear button is button 1. Okay, so whenever button 1 is clicked, as the variables are working with the list, so we need to first clear the list. After that, we will clear the list viewer. So first click on variables, get the set variable, set global dictation. Set global dictation to click on lists and get the create empty list. Okay. Whenever button 1 is clicked, then the global dictation will be cleared completely. And also the list view should be cleared. So click on list view, set list view elements to this one, get global dictation. Okay, so click on variables again and get this block. Okay, so whenever the clear button will be clicked, at first the global dictation will be cleared, will be emptied, and then the list view will be cleared by setting the global dictation, because the global dictation will be first cleared, so it will be empty. Now the empty variable will be added in the elements of the list view, so the whole list will be cleared. Okay, so this is the final coding. Now let's test the app. Okay, so let's test it out. Whenever I turn on the switch and say something, it will record my words. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
How are you?
Interval.
Interval.
Mouse.
Mouse.
Clock.
Clock.
Hello. Okay, so now as you can see, I have turned off the switch and now I am speaking, it is not recording anymore. If I tap the clear button, it will clear all the words in the list. There is a bug or problem which you may face while using this app. Before I tell you anything, watch this clip. I am fine, thank you.
I am fine, thank you. Thank you.
As you can see here, when I said, I am fine, thank you, the speech of mine was added in the list. But then, although I didn't say anything, the words thank you were added in the list again. This happened because of the text-to-speech. Remember, I had set the clock's time interval to 1000 milliseconds or 1 second. That means the speech recognizer will just start after every 1 second. And here comes the problem. If our speech is too long, then the text-to-speech will take at least or more than 1 second to speak what we say. So at that time, while the text-to-speech will be talking, after the time limit of 1 second, the speech recognizer will turn on and thus will get the speech from the phone speaker and write that down in the list, although we didn't pronounce a single word. Watch this animation carefully and try to understand the fact.
I am fine, thank you. Thank you.
I am fine, thank you.
Okay, hope you understood the issue. Let's fix it now. There are two different ways to fix this out. Method 1 is that you delete the text-to-speech and do not use it. By this, the app will only add our speech in the list and won't talk. As a result, the speech recognizer will also not get any unnecessary text from the speaker of the phone. Method 2. If you don't want to remove the text-to-speech and want the app to talk back, then you can increase the time interval of the clock to something like 5000 milliseconds or 5 seconds or 10,000 milliseconds or 10 seconds or more if you want. By this, the speech recognizer will restart after a long time interval, and by then, the text-to-speech should finish saying your speech aloud. Okay, that's all for part 2. In part 3, we will make a continuous speech recognition app with the default continuous speech recognition feature of the speech recognizer version 8. And you won't need the clock tool to use that default continuous speech recognizer. Stay tuned for part 3 by subscribing and turning on all notifications to get notified whenever I upload that video. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned, stay safe.